Rise and shine, mothers and brothers and cheese wedges and chin straps and handlebars all over the world. Rise and shine. It's a beautiful day. Thank you for joining me on my ride to work. Today's Rise and Shine is brought to you today by Aqualung. Reason being, I'm playing this all day long on the Pandora. All day long. If you don't like it, Jay-Z will not be played, I'm sorry. Beyonce will not be played, I'm sorry. Daft Punk will not be played, I'm sorry. Bruno Mars will not be played, I'm sorry. Jethro Tull, Aqualung, all day. If you don't like it, then you're going to have someone else line you up, because that's not happening. Hey, good morning, how are you? On the ride to work today, scoop of protein, scoop of fiber, my vitamins. What else? A carrot. Tablespoon of peanut butter. 10 ice cubes. Green tea. Right here, man. What else is in there? Tablespoon of Greek yogurt. Beard is unplugged AF today. I did it yesterday, and I'm kind of enjoying it because normally my hair is just a little straighter than most people's. For me, this is a curly beard, and it's literally an inch shorter than when I normally comb it and blow dry it. I got out of the shower today. Everything, I'm just full-blown Aqualung today, man. Full-blown Aqualung. Right here, that's me today. Get out of the shower, just shook everything like a madman, and that was it. No comb. I did put a little bit of oil on, only because Kiehl's oil that has Prakashi in it. You gotta try the Kiehl's. Try the Kiehl's. K-I-E-H-L-S. Try it. Try everything. People say, what's the best one? I go, whatever one works for you. What's the best mustache wax? Whatever works for you. What's the best oil? Whatever works for you. What's the best comb? Whatever works for you. That's what works. Every beard is different. That's why I think every beard is beautiful, because everyone reacts different. You're not all gonna react, your beard's not gonna react like this one today. What's weird is when I comb and blow dry my beard, I don't feel it. Today I feel it because it's curlier and fluffier, and I'm actually feeling it on my skin. The other days, it just kind of hangs, and I don't feel it. Excuse me while I adjust my mirrors in my high-tech luxury car here, okay? With 225,000 miles on it. I don't mess around, man. I drive cars till they die. And this car, this 1.8-liter Toyota Infiniti engine, is kicking ass, man. It's sick. It's crazy. I think the car will die before, like, the car will die before the engine does. I think nothing about driving this car anywhere. It's incredible. 225,130 miles. I get about 35 miles a gallon consistently. If I'm on a straight highway, just with a consistent speed, I get a little bit more. Round town, I get a little bit less. I'm the kind of guy that says every family should have a utility vehicle. I always had a truck. Always had like a Ford Explorer, that kind of thing. When I was married, we had the Toyota Corolla. We had the Ford Explorer. Utility. You know, when you got kids and baby seats and all that stuff like that, you're running out to Home Depot and getting large bags of mulch or different things, you know, and you don't always want to be borrowing trucks. So it's nice to have a utility vehicle. I always say every family should have something, a van, a truck, some type of SUV, something with a large cargo area that you're not jacking up when you put stuff in it. At this point here, I could load this I could load this car up with a yard of mulch and it wouldn't make any difference. It's so old, but I love it. What brand is your favorite brand? Whatever works for you. That's my favorite. My favorite is whatever works for you. People say, what's your favorite brand? Me. I am my favorite brand. Gray Bailey is my brand. My attitude, opinion, and perspective is my brand. Can I endorse products? Sure. I'm brutally honest. Somebody sends me a product, I let you know how it works. The guys from Can You Handlebar gave me a bunch of product. Full disclosure, gave me product at the hair show. My assessment of Can You Handlebar on a scale of 1 to 10, I'll give it a 10. It's superior. They can't improve on it. It's perfect. It works perfect. That, and believe me, that's not, if the product sucked, I would tell you it sucks. If it's a 2, I'd tell you it's a 2, but it's superior. That's the beauty of capitalism in America and across the world. If a product doesn't work, it's not going to be sold. When products fly off the shelf, that means they're good. That means people like them and keep buying them. They're consumable items. When they're done, when the package is done, when the tin is empty, guess what? A guy starts jonesing for another one. Or a few days or a week before he uses his last bit of mustache wax, he makes another order on Amazon or goes to the company directly. I like it when you order direct from the company, because that way the money goes into the pockets of the manufacturer, which I think is preferable. But I do appreciate other portals, sales portals as well. Hey, let's talk about fear today. Let's talk about fear. And not like you're afraid and crouching behind the bed kind of fear. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about things that you hesitate doing. Ah, man, that's good. That'll keep me till lunch when I have a salad. And I'm no longer eating junk for lunch. I work in a damn mall. All right? So can you imagine if I ate mall food every day? So I had to make a choice. I go to this place that like just has all fresh vegetables. They pop them in a big bowl, mix them up, chop them up. I always get my salad chopped with those curved blades. They chop, 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 chop. That way I'm not getting everything in my beard. One of the gals I work with, I went out to lunch with her yesterday. There was only two of us in the store, so we had to lock the store for a little bit, go out and grab lunch. I'm eating, she's looking at me and she says, you know, you have a carrot in your beard. And my response is, that's all? Think about it. When you have a big beard, man, it's just, that's life. You know how Frank Sinatra says, that's life. I got food in my beard. That's life. I mean, that's the way it is, man. You just kind of, you live with a napkin in your hand, constantly wiping. You travel with straws. That's life. With a big old beard. Now, if you're all lined up and listening to Pharrell singing, I'm happy, then you don't have to worry about stuff like that. But I don't roll like that. I roll with Tull and Zeppelin. And no, hey, and Aerosmith and Guns N' Roses. That's how I roll. I like all music, though. I do. I appreciate all music. I really do. But I'd rather listen to Steely Dan than Pharrell. That's just my opinion. All right, let's talk about fear. You are born with two fears, the fear of loud noises and the fear of falling. Babies have two innate. When I say the word innate, that means that's something you're born with. It's part of the natural instinct inside of a baby. The fear of falling, if a baby goes to fall, it reaches out quick. It startles a baby. Loud noises will startle a baby. And those are natural protective instincts that cause that fight or flight response within the human being. Fear of falling. See, I just waved a dude on, man. He waved back. Give him a peace sign. You know what? You give somebody a break on the road, guess what, man? You get a break. That's the way that works. You give a break, you get a break. And guess what? Here's a really cool way to live. How about giving a break without expecting to get a break? How about just be the guy that gives breaks all day long, or be the gal that gives breaks all day? What a beautiful way to live free. You know what? Because you give. Now, there's a dude on the walking path. Right now, there's a walking path along here. He's doing push-ups. He probably walked, ran, stopped. He's on the grass now doing push-ups. He looks like he's 50 years old. That's cool, man. I love it when people take care of themselves. Hey, take care of yourself, will you, dude? I have to, you know? Don't be like me. I make all the mistakes, so you don't have to. Go to the doctor. She says you're going to have a heart attack or stroke within 6 months if you don't make some changes. Okay, that's pretty convincing. Blood pressure through the roof, sugar through the roof. All of my numbers sucked. Because I haven't been to a doctor in 10 years, and I didn't give a crap, and I'm eating a whole pizza, drinking, and it just ain't good. So I made changes in the past month. Literally, I've made major changes in the past month that are incredible. I feel great. So here's the deal. Babies are born with two fears. Fear of falling, fear of loud noises. Now here's the important part. Every other fear is learned. When you were born, you had two fears in you. Fear of falling and fear of loud noises. Everything else you're afraid of, you learned. You got that? You learned it. Afraid to get married again? Right here, me. I learned it the hard way. Fear of taking a job that I don't like? I learned that fear. Fear of maybe asking somebody out because of rejection? Right here. It's all learned. But then when you can retrain your brain, realign, rewire your neurons by practicing. Like, for instance, if you're doing yoga, you can't put your leg behind your head the first time. You might just get it up to your waist, and then maybe to your chest, and then maybe to your chin. Increments, okay? Fear is the same way. You might fear something and just almost... Remember what I said a couple days ago? The biggest reaction to fear is paralysis. People just don't do anything. How about... You don't have to dive off the Empire State Building, okay? Believe it or not, I didn't learn how to dive. I knew how to swim, but I didn't know how to dive until I was probably 35 years old. And now I'm closer to 60 than 50. But think about it. Now I dive. I love diving. When I'm near water, I dive in. But I was so afraid. You know how it started? It started being in the water. Actually, in the water. Standing in the water up to my chest and just going forward in the water. And I think it was just like I was afraid of water up my nose, or the discomfort of water up my nose. And I don't know what that was. There's so many people that are afraid of swimming and diving and all that, and deep water. Not me. But it started incrementally. I learned that. You know what happened? When I was a little kid, I'll never forget, one of my dad's friends picked me up and threw me in a pool. I was like snapping him with a towel. I was like just like a little wise ass little kid snapping one of my dad's friends with a towel out of the patio in the backyard. He picked me up, threw me in the pool. I went to the bottom. My dad had to dive in and get me. It was all funny to them, not to me. And I was afraid of water. It took me forever to learn how to swim. Thank God we had a pool in my little tiny backyard. I was raised poor, middle class. Didn't have a lot, but I didn't know it. I got 1,000 times more now than I did when I was growing up. My kids are like bazillionaires compared to what I was when I was a kid. But I didn't know it. I didn't care. I had a bike. I could climb trees. A few blocks away was the city. A few blocks away was the woods, creeks. It was all good. I loved it. But fear is learned. What do you fear? Starting a business? Having a new venture? Asking somebody out who you think or you're afraid they're going to say no? What is the worst that can happen? That's one way to help rewire the neurons. What is the worst that can happen? You know I'm a big fan of this right here. Writing stuff down, man. Pen, paper, write stuff down. Write down at the top of the paper, what is the worst that can happen? And then list the worst things that can happen. Read them out loud. I'm a big fan of writing stuff down and reading it out loud. And then when you read back to yourself out loud, the worst that can happen, something occurs. It occurs to you that it really isn't that bad, is it? So let's go back to the diving example. You don't have to dive off the top of a building into a pool. You can start while you're in the pool, and then the edge of the pool, and then a diving board. Incrementally, you can retrain yourself behaviorally. You know, they say behavior that gets rewarded gets repeated. Celebrate your little victories. Think about it. I'll say this again. Behavior that gets rewarded gets repeated. Now that works with children and pets and other people. But what if you're a solo practitioner? What if you're kind of a loner? What if you're like me? I wouldn't call myself a loner. I'm an introvert with serious extrovert tendencies. I prefer time alone, although I do social very well. But my default state is always solo, is always solitude. Man, I love solitude. I went camping once by myself. I had a very profound experience. Let me share this with you. I went camping. Tent, hammock. I didn't even bring a camp stove. I cooked everything on a fire. Tent, hammock, flashlight. And this was even before the LED flashlights. This is like when the flashlights were like 5 pounds. Big old batteries and stuff. And I remember being in the woods. I went on a Friday night. I came back on a Sunday. So for 2 nights, slept in a tent, had a campfire outside the tent, strung up a hammock, and I bought a stack of comic books. I happen to like comic books. I was reading, now they call them graphic novels, but I was reading like kind of like not just superhero stuff, but more, weird tales, tales from the crypt, weird science, the old 50s comics, like old sci-fi comics. And I like the more weird, darker comics, like Sandman. I don't know if you're into Sandman at all. Really love that stuff. But that's the kind of stuff that I read. I'm talking like a stack, like 50 comics. And I spent the weekend reading comics, swinging on a hammock, sitting by the fire, reading the comics by flashlight. And this was a real trip. I enjoyed myself so much. This is what I said. When I went to the campgrounds, it was like a regular campgrounds. I didn't backpack anywhere. I went to a campgrounds, drove 2 hours to it, up in the Poconos. Beautiful area, a lot of great trails up there, hiking during the day and so forth, campfires at night. I think the only thing that I said was, 2 nights please, and then thank you to the camp ranger. And that was it. I went a whole weekend, literally 2.5 days, without saying a word, without speaking, and I was by myself. Can you, Matt, have you gone? How many days have you gone without saying a word? Now that's a trip, man. That is a trip. And all you're doing is listening and not talking. Can you imagine living like that? For a while I could do it. But it was fun. It was beautiful. And I loved being by myself. with zero expectations except the expectations that I have for myself. Nobody was expecting me to be anywhere or do anything. Gotta close that window. I prefer natural air over AC. I like a fan blowing and circulating air as opposed to air conditioning. I don't mind the heat as much. You know, I might bitch and moan about heat, but when it's with humidity, that's different. But I like moving air. My body seems to adjust well to heat and humidity. Back to fear. Break down your fear into little pieces and start working on it. If you had an injury and you're afraid to go to the same area, let's say you tore something when you were bench pressing. Well, no one says you have to go back to bench pressing 350 pounds. Guess what? You can bench press the bar. The 30-pound bar. Bench press that. Let's say you were like slinging around, you know, 50 to 100-pound dumbbells and you blew out a shoulder. No one says you have to go back to 100-pound dumbbells. But you're afraid you're going to look like a girl if you use 3-pound dumbbells. Do it. Go back incrementally. Get the motion in. You know about muscle memory. There's neuron memory as well. You ever hear the phrase, it's like riding a bike? People say the phrase, it's like riding a bike, when it comes to learning things or certain things that are hard to unlearn. Like once you learn how to ride a bike, it's hard to unlearn it. You get on and ride it. I learned how to inline skate. That's another thing. I actually want to take some lessons. I want to be the most badass inline skater. I want to be the guy with the big, long, white beard skating on the boardwalk. That's what I want to be. I want to be the old dude with the beard down to here, long AF, skating on the boardwalk. And people saying, look at that old dude, man, look at him go. Of course, you get out there early in the morning before the crowds get out there. It's not so much the skating, it's learning how to stop that you really know how to. You know, that is true. When you learn how to skate, skating is the easy part. It's learning how to stop. That's the hard part. And you have to learn 5 different ways to stop. I want to skate backwards, man. I want to jump. I don't want to be a daredevil because I'm not stupid. And I don't have the flexibility and strength that I used to have. Although I can still rumble pretty well, like the Toby Keith song says. Anyways, incrementally, attack your fears little by little. You can do it. You only, whatever you're afraid of, realize it was learned. You only have 2 inborn fears, a fear of falling and the fear of loud noises. Do you have them now? No, you don't. You know why? Because you unlearned the fear of falling. You still go to brace yourself. If you feel like you're going to slip or trip, you move to brace yourself. That's natural. Fear of loud noises. Most people, when they hear a loud noise, you know, they startle a little bit. You still have a little bit of that in you, but it's not as raw as it was when you were a baby. You can do it. Because you rock, and you're awesome, and I believe in you. Have a great day. George Bruno, also known as the Sultan of Silver. Just go to my website, georgebruno.com, and you will find everything that you possibly could want. And I appreciate you watching. I really, really do. Have a super day.